So now we're going to do sex-linked crosses. Now, you know, humans have 23 pairs of chromosomes. 22 out of 23 are usually totally homologous. That, again, means that they code for the same thing, all right? But the last pair of chromosomes are the sex chromosomes. And you could have an X or a Y. You could have two Xs. Sometimes people get a different combination of those. But it's what chromosomes you get usually determine what your biological sex is. It can actually be a lot more complicated than that. Biological sex is not a binary. Gender is not a binary. Those are actually two different things. You can learn more about that in my gender lecture. But why I'm talking about that now in genetics is that a trait that's on the X chromosome, whether or not that trait is, or how that trait affects you is going to differ based on which chromosomes you have. So what that means is that we usually, most people who get an XX are usually female, and people who get an XY are usually male. Again, not always. Now, if we're looking at a gene that's on the X chromosome and you're XX, how many copies of that gene did you get? You got two copies, right? But if you're XY and that trait is only found on the X chromosome, well, how many X chromosomes do you have? Only one. So you're actually only going to get one copy of that allele. Okay, it's going to be different than what we've seen before. You only get one copy of that gene because it's not going to be on that Y chromosome. Like it's literally like a little dinky, weeny little chromosome with not much on it. The SRY gene is on it, the sex-determining region of the Y chromosome, which usually determines your sex, but again, not always. So the characteristic that people usually use the sex-linked crosses is color blindness, because that's something that's on the X chromosome, having the color vision or not, and that's distinguishing between red and green. If you have, I don't want to say normal, but if you have color vision, then you can distinguish between those two colors. But if you're red-green colorblind, they look the same to you. They look like they're the same color and you can't distinguish. And the genes on those, that Y chromosome will determine whether you can do that or not. That's why color blindness and other sex-linked crosses, they're going to affect people who are male more often than they are female. I'll show you how. So let's do a cross. So let's have our parents cross is, let's have someone who's female. Let's say that she has color vision. Again, I don't like the word normal. What we're going to do is we're going to superscript over her chromosomes, okay? Because we have to distinguish which chromosomes they have. So that's going to determine how many copies of the allele that they get. And let's say we cross her with a guy who is colorblind, okay? Having colorblindness is recessive, so he's going to have a little B right there, right? And then his Y chromosome over here is not going to have anything on it. It's not found on the Y chromosome. This particular trait is only found on the X chromosome. So if you've got two Xs, you got two copies, just like we saw with the flowers and the peas. You got two copies of that gene. But if you're XY, you only got one X chromosome. So you only got one chance to get a dominant allele and have the dominant phenotype. So if you happen to get just one recessive allele, you'll be colorblind here, okay? So let's do a cross. Oh, let's do a Punnett square. So here. So mom over here, the F1, we'll do a Punnett square of. So all of her eggs, they're all going to be the same. They're all going to be X, B. We could be redundant and do it twice, but you don't have to. They're all the same. So all of her eggs, they're all going to be an X chromosome. You know, I'll do it twice. So just be as clear as possible. So they're all going to have a dominant allele B, a big B. That's all she has. Dad, okay, half of his sperm are going to have the X chromosome, which happens to have that recessive allele for color blindness. Half of his sperm are going to be a Y, okay? Sperm. Again, these are gametes, right? Okay. There's all my pens here. So just like we've done for all the other crosses, bring them down and across. So this square, again, these are eggs. Okay, bring them across. Okay, big X, big B, being redundant, it's okay. Okay, okay, all those eggs there. So there's a 50-50 chance of a sperm. Maybe you didn't know this, but it's actually the father's sperm that usually determines the biological sex of the offspring. So if an X sperm, a sperm with an X chromosome, fertilizes that egg, it's usually a girl. Okay, bring them down, you see. Okay. A with happens to have that little recessive allele there. If it's a Y sperm, it's usually a boy. Okay. All right. So like these are probably the daughters over here. Okay. These are probably the sons over here. So what's going on here? So are any of these kids colorblind? No, actually they all have at least one dominant allele. All of, so they all have color vision. They can distinguish between between red and green. So let's cross this carrier woman with a guy who is not colorblind. He has normal color vision. He has one dominant allele. That's all he needs for normal color vision. And she is a carrier, so she got that recessive allele that she got from her dad. Remember, who was colorblind? Remember, he was like this. Okay. And he gave the Y to his sons, and he gave his little B here to his daughters, and she got it here. So let's do the same thing. Bring them down and across. So this one across, this egg across. Okay, this one across. Okay, and then being fertilized by these sperm here. Okay, bringing these down, and this Y here. Okay, so again, so we have the daughters probably on the left, sons on the right. Are the daughters colorblind? No, they have at least one in this case, two in this case, dominant allele, so they have normal color vision. But the sons over here, half the sons are gonna get the big B from mom, half the sons are gonna get the little B from mom, okay? Because that's where sons get their X chromosomes from, is from mom. So there's a 25% chance of having a kid that's colorblind. If we're just looking at the sons, there's a 50% chance. So this is why colorblindness and other sex-linked crosses disproportionately affect males, because they only got one chance to get that dominant allele, and they didn't. So if you got a recessive allele, you have the condition, you have colorblindness. Whereas the females are kind of like, it's getting like overridden by that dominant allele right there. So it is possible if you had two X's and they both had a recessive allele for a female to be colorblind, it's just not as common because you have, you know, twice the chances of getting a dominant allele. All right, so now we're gonna do a cross of a woman who's a carrier for colorblindness. Now a carrier is someone who carries the gene but is not afflicted with it themselves. So they're heterozygous. So she has the gene for colorblindness, but she's kind of like being protected by that gene over there that she got from her mom. So no, she got both, one from mom, one from dad. This one was from dad. This X chromosome she got from dad, this X chromosome she got from mom, right here. Okay, so she passed it down to her daughter. So let's cross her with another guy who is also colorblind. Okay, he has a recessive allele there. So let's now cross them. Okay, so same thing, bringing them down and across. So bring the eggs across, these eggs, now this one has that recessive allele there, okay, with the sperm from this guy, it's floppy, you can see that, okay. Okay, bringing it down, so those are the daughters here, probably, these sperm over here, maybe probably boys, okay. So it's a little bit different. So XX on the left here, daughters, XY on the right here, sons. This daughter right here is actually colorblind because she got the recessive allele from mom here and also the recessive allele from dad here. So it is possible for girls to be colorblind. It's just not as common. What's going on here is this X is fertilized by this Y right here. And here we have a son who's colorblind.